Gildan Media, a division of Recorded Books, presents Entrepreneur Voices on the Science of Success by the staff of Entrepreneur Media, Inc., edited by Jonathan Small, narrated by Stephen R. Thorne and Susan Hanfield. Foreword by Ben Angel, marketing expert and best-selling author. What do peak performers do that I don't? If the strategies of the ultra-successful are so great, then why do I fall short when I apply them? If you've ever asked yourself these questions, know that you're not alone. I myself have learned over the years that the science of success isn't as black and white as the self-help gurus have led us to believe. They tell us to quit making excuses, but fail to break down why we make excuses based on a deep understanding of not just psychology, but the science of success as a whole. For years, I beat myself up, wondering why I couldn't reach my goals sooner, if at all. It's only recently that I've been able to look beneath the surface and gain new insight as to why we do what we do and why some strategies work for some and fail miserably for others. To find the answers to these questions, I traveled from Australia to the U.S. and Canada to interview top neuroscientists, biohackers, functional doctors, and psychologists to gain a comprehensive and complete understanding of the essence of the science of success. What I learned shocked me. Success cannot be distilled down into any one simple strategy like waking up at 5 a.m. each day or making your bed every morning. Instead, it's made up of a combination of strategies that only when applied in unison provide the catalyst for real breakthroughs to occur across every area of our businesses and lives. You have likely compared yourself to your heroes to only ever feel like you come up short. You're not as productive as you'd like to be, you're easily overwhelmed, or you lack the structure to pull off your most ambitious goals. We've all been there. But you can get past questioning yourself and get to a place where you feel that success is not only possible, but probable. The bottom line is this. To unlock your capacity, you have to try many different keys until you find the ones that click for you. What works for a billionaire, you or me, is as individual as a fingerprint and must be treated as such. But where do you start? Step one is in your hands. Entrepreneur Voices on the Science of Success is a must-listen book for anyone looking to re-energize themselves, increase their productivity, boost their confidence, and rapidly transform their business. It presents science-backed research that you can easily experiment with and habits you can add to your routine, all without wasting hours reading about it online. The strategies shared here are from the best of the best, including experts like Deepak Chopra, CEOs of billion-dollar companies, business advisors, researchers, and the incredible entrepreneur editorial team members who have dedicated their lives to helping millions fulfill their ambitions. Know that you're in safe hands as you walk through actionable, bite-sized insights that will show you how to use neuroscience, brain hacks, and habits to help rewire your mind for success and change the way you tackle your entrepreneurial to-do list forever. You'll discover how to crush your goals, create powerful habits, become more likable, generate word-of-mouth marketing for your business, and build a billion-dollar company. So, if you have an insatiable thirst to uncover how to turn yourself into a peak performer, this book will become a mainstay on your desk, especially when you need an injection of inspiration, an easy-to-apply strategy for dialing in your focus, or a path to rapidly growing your business. If you're ready to see success in your business and life, grab a cup of coffee, pen, and paper, because your life is about to be transformed in ways you've never imagined. Preface. Achieve your goals with science. Is success a science? Like hitting a baseball or solving a math equation, Can it be narrowed down into actionable nuggets of proven knowledge and skills that you can apply to your life and your business? These are the questions everyone, from scientists to academics, psychologists to sociologists, is studying at this very moment. And the answer, at least so far, is this. While science may not provide all the solutions, it is an essential ingredient in any business endeavor. To ignore or discount it is, well, scientifically short-sighted. There is simply too much data and cutting-edge research available at your fingertips to not take advantage of it immediately. Through science, entrepreneurs are discovering new ways to increase their business's productivity, identify customer needs, and implement policies proven to attract and retain business. By studying how people engage with their products, they are creating customer-friendly tools and policies that are winning a new business and maximizing profits. By studying how high-performing individuals think and act, they are adopting principles and practices that lead to more fruitful and satisfying lives. The science of success can be split into two categories: knowledge that can be applied to your life and knowledge that can be applied to your business. The two are not mutually exclusive. In fact, a combination platter of the two can be the best course of action. So, what are some things entrepreneurs can learn from science? While it's true that some entrepreneurs inherently possess certain essential traits, such as confidence, passion, and dedication, we now know through neuroscience how to condition and rewire our brains to think in similar ways. Researchers also have a much better understanding of how we establish routines and habits. By pinpointing the biological reasons behind why we behave the way we do, they can recommend specific brain hacks to help us achieve our dreams. Thanks to science, we also have a better understanding of the importance of impressions and influence. New studies reveal fascinating insights on how to be more memorable, both in a good and a not-so-good way. As much as science can help us understand ourselves, it is equally useful in helping entrepreneurs understand their businesses and their customers. Human psychology teaches us a great deal about how to interact with customers, both on and offline. And sophisticated data gives us more business intelligence than we believed possible even 10 years ago. Gone are the days of relying solely on your gut instincts to make decisions. Entrepreneurs are now loaded with as many facts and data points as they need to make informed choices. This book lays out some of the cutting-edge and common-sense science available to you as a business owner. It is not a how-to guide to success. Think of it more as a buffet of fact-driven research that you can choose to ingest or ignore. Science cannot make you successful. Only you can do that. But it can provide you with real and tangible data about the tactics, skills, knowledge, and routines of successful people in business. As one of the preeminent scientists of our time, Neil deGrasse Tyson, once said, "The good thing about science is that it's true, whether or not you believe in it." Part 1. Habits that increase productivity. Warren Buffett starts every morning poring over 500 pages of magazines, newspapers, and books. The first thing Tim Ferris does when he wakes up is make his bed. Sheryl Sandberg makes sure to get to work at Facebook every day at 7 a.m. sharp. Like many highly successful entrepreneurs, all these business leaders have developed habits that they believe increase their focus and productivity. And these are not just the eccentric quirks of multimillionaires. Increasingly, scientific studies show that by dropping bad habits and developing and bolstering good ones, you can set yourself up to achieve your goals and dreams. Let's face it, the word habit gets a bad rap. From the time we're children, we're told to break habits, not build them. And as we become adults, most of us associate habits with negative routines, like constantly checking our smartphones, biting our nails, or drinking too much coffee. Those are not the habits we're talking about, although some studies have found that coffee is actually good for you. The habits of successful entrepreneurs broaden your mind, increase your energy and enthusiasm, and actually rewire your brain to think in a whole new way. So, which habits should you develop and which should you drop? Like breakfast cereal, habits come in all sorts of varieties and options. There are habits we think are beneficial but are actually impeding our progress. Multitasking is a prime example. While most of us brag about our ability to juggle answering email, talking on the phone, and conducting a meeting at the same time, scientists are not impressed. In fact, studies show that interweaving two or more tasks is the least effective way to gain comprehension. Then there are the habits that we think are detrimental but are actually helpful. It is commonly believed that being a workaholic is a recipe for stress and antisocial behavior. And that's largely true for workaholics who hate their jobs. But studies have shown that people who put in long hours on the job, but who are engaged and enthusiastic about their work, tend to be happier and more productive than the stereotypical workaholic, who can suffer from health problems, sleep disorders, and depression. Lastly, there are the habits that we might not have thought of, but that have been adopted by some of the most successful and fulfilled people in business. These are the behavioral modifications that, when practiced on a daily basis, can transform our performance from good to great. From brain hacks to breaking bad habits, from small behavioral changes like meditating 10 minutes every day to larger commitments, such as spending 80% of your day reading, like Warren Buffett, the following chapters lay out a science-backed roadmap to success. Chapter 1. 9 Science-Backed Insights on Finding Success in Business and Life. Entrepreneur Staff. Whether at work or at home, success is something we strive for in all aspects of our lives. And while there are a number of obvious things you should be doing to achieve your goals, there are also some not-so-obvious ones. For example, we're often told that working too much can be detrimental to our health and wellness. However, a study found that high engagement actually protects from health risks associated with working too much. And being too happy around coworkers might make you seem naive rather than simply optimistic. From office jokes to sales leads to patients, check out these 9 science-backed insights to help you achieve success. 1. Workaholism has an upside. Those who work more than 11 hours a day have been shown to have a higher risk of heart disease, high blood pressure, obesity, and high cholesterol. But there's better news for happy workaholics. High engagement may protect you from these risks. According to the Harvard Business Review, companies see a spike in productivity and a dip in turnover when workaholics are focused and content in their jobs. 2. Office jokes are risky. According to a study by the Wharton School, humor can increase your status at work, make you appear more competent, and make you more likely to be elected as a group leader. But that's only if your jokes are appropriate. An off-color or bad joke can backfire and diminish your status, leaving coworkers thinking you're incompetent. 3. Dial down the happy. Employees who are too outwardly upbeat are seen as naive and unsophisticated. Why? Research finds that overly happy employees are perceived as more vulnerable to deception or exploitation. While it's good to be positive, it is not always motivating, inspiring, or even attractive to your coworkers. Instead, try to focus on being thoughtful and wise about the people and the world around you. 4. Experiment with different sales techniques. When it comes to generating sales, you should be open to all sorts of different approaches. One size does not fit all. For example, to generate leads for its online course-building services, PLR.me tried using a chatbot and found that 78% of people who engaged with it stayed through to the end. 5. Be patient. In his TED Talk, What I Learned from 2,000 Obituaries, Lux Narayan, CEO of Unmetric, says, "We looked at the data. 2,000 editorial, non-paid obituaries over a 20-month period between 2015 and 2016. What did these 2,000 deaths, rather lives, teach us? The average age at which they achieved things is 37. What that means is you've got to wait 37 years before your first significant achievement that you're remembered for, on average, 44 years later, when you die at the age of 81. Talk about having to be patient. 6. Go for FaceTime. Despite the ease of digital communication, sometimes good old-fashioned FaceTime is the most effective communication technique. A study found face-to-face requests are 34 times more successful than emails. 7. Get psyched up. In his book, Psyched Up: How the Science of Mental Preparation Can Help You Succeed, Daniel McGinn writes, "For people who suffer from extreme nerves, don't obsess over calming down. Instead, tell yourself that the sweaty palms and the racing heart are a positive sign, because they signify excitement. You're lucky to be here and to have this opportunity to prove how good you are." 8. More is better. On average, creative geniuses aren't qualitatively better in their fields than their peers. They simply produced a greater volume of work, which gave them more variation and a higher chance of originality, writes Adam Grant in his book, Originals: How Nonconformists Move the World. To generate a handful of masterworks, Mozart composed more than 600 pieces before his death at 35. Beethoven produced 650 in his lifetime. Einstein wrote papers on general and special relativity that transformed physics, but many of his 248 publications had minimal impact. 9. Get to work. According to David Autor, professor of economics at MIT, many of the great inventions of the last 200 years were designed to replace human labor. Assembly lines were engineered to replace inconsistent human handiwork with machine perfection. Computers were programmed to swap out error-prone, inconsistent human calculation with digital perfection. And yet, the fraction of U.S. adults employed in the labor market is higher now in 2016 than it was 125 years ago. Machines may be able to do many of our jobs, but they haven't replaced us completely. So get started.
Chapter 2: Science-Backed Brain Hacks to Crush Your Goals. Kate Rockwood. Often the hardest part of achieving success is when you transition your goals into habits. Goals tell you where you want to go, but habits give you the discipline you need to get there. It may seem daunting, but the process will get easier with time. All it takes now is persistence, passion, and a little science-backed knowledge to get you over the hump. Here are 7 tips that will help you keep pushing. 1. Get bold. Want to push your performance to the max? Make a stretch goal rather than one that's easily attainable. Stretch goals push you beyond your usual limits. Penn State psychology professors found in a study that big, lofty goals are correlated more strongly with improved performance than small, incremental goals. The higher the bar, the harder we push. 2. Narrow your focus. So you want to pitch 20 new clients, build out the product line, and scout a second location. Time to pare down that to-do list. In a study in the Journal of Marketing Research, participants who picked just one goal achieved success at nearly double the rate of those who chased two or three at a time. 3. Grab a pen. Got a goal? Write it down. In a study at Dominican University, people who wrote down their objectives achieved roughly 50% more than people who merely thought about them. 4. Think in ranges. A study published in the Journal of Consumer Research shows that setting a goal within a range, say raising revenue 8 to 10%, makes you more likely to stick with it than if you aim for a flat number. Even better, you'll be more likely to try to set a goal again in the future, says lead researcher Maura Scott, a professor at Florida State University. 5. Map it out. A goal is great. A game plan is even better. In a study in the Journal of Applied Psychology, participants who spent 2 hours mapping out how they plan to achieve specific goals were more likely to find success. The researchers wrote, "Goal clarity increases persistence, making individuals less susceptible to the undermining effects of anxiety, disappointment, and frustration." 6. Enlist a friend. An accountability buddy can work just as well in the boardroom as at the gym. Research shows that when people share weekly progress reports with a friend, their likelihood of success at reaching a goal climbs to 76%. 7. Cue the immediate gratification. Our brains naturally want to put off daunting tasks and let our future selves deal with them. The psych term for this is present bias. But a 2016 study in the Chicago Booth Review offers a way around your inner procrastinator. Give yourself small rewards in the near future to spur greater achievement of long-term goals. A slice of cake every time you cold call an investor. A Friday night Netflix binge every week you advance the ball on your big goal. Whatever keeps you inching toward the finish line. 8. Get unmotivated. Okay, it sounds completely counterintuitive, but a study by the British Journal of Health Psychology found that trying to motivate yourself to reach a goal was less effective than setting an intention for when and what you want to accomplish. Researchers reported that people who read motivational materials were less likely to get things done, while people who made a plan and followed through were much more successful. By implementing these strategies into your regimen, you slowly train your brain to think about your goals and success in new ways. What may start off as a marathon eventually becomes a sprint. Chapter 3. Why You Should Stop Saying Sorry, According to Science. Rose Leadham. If you hurt someone's feelings or turn someone down, saying sorry might not be the best solution. In fact, an apology might just add fuel to the fire. A study by researchers from Dartmouth College and the University of Texas has found. To assess the impact of apologies after social rejections, researchers approached more than 1,000 people, asked them questions, and had them participate in several experiments. When asked to write a good way of saying no to a social request, 39% of participants included an apology with the belief that it would lighten the situation. However, when they were put on the receiving end of these notes, they reported feeling more hurt. Apologies can actually anger people and trigger them to strike back, the researchers found. In another experiment, they conducted face-to-face rejections to understand how rejectees actually felt after an incident. People often don't want to admit that they have hurt feelings, so in some of the studies, we looked at how much people wanted to seek revenge, explains the study's lead author, Dr. Jilly Friedman. In the experiment, when rejected with an apology from participating in a taste test, rejectees got even. Many gave more hot sauce to the person who rejected them after they were told the individual did not like spicy food. It doesn't stop there. Whether sincere or not, when people receive apologies, they often feel like they have to forgive the person, even if they are not ready. After asking participants to watch videos of people being rejected, when a person received an apology along with the rejection, most viewers felt that person was obliged to forgive, even if they didn't actually feel it. Our research finds that despite their good intentions, people are going about it the wrong way, Friedman says. Even if you choose to apologize, you should realize that there is a science to saying I'm sorry. One study analyzed 183 public apologies from famous people. They found that when the apology included a denial, it wasn't me, or evasion, let's change the subject, it didn't sit well with fans, according to opinion polls. But when the apology contained elements of remorse, I'm mortified, or correction, I will never do this again, that was a more effective approach.
Chapter 4. 9 Proven Habits of Highly Innovative People. Deep Patel. The biggest success stories always hinge on innovation and creating breakthroughs no one else achieved. The people behind these departures from the norm are revolutionaries. They are courageous enough to step away from the tried and true methods to carve their own way forward. Innovative people disrupt whole industries with their ideas. Their brain children take on lives of their own and may impact generations to come. So what gives these super creative people their edge? How do they tap into that talent? For one, they've learned to cultivate certain habits that support and heighten their creativity. Here are 9 proven habits that highly innovative people use daily. 1. Pursue your passions. Creative people tend to be intrinsically motivated, meaning that their desire comes from within. This internal desire spurs them to pursue their dreams. Innovative people feel compelled to follow their passions. They are energized by challenging activities. Highly innovative and successful people aren't necessarily the most talented of the bunch, but they consistently and persistently go after their goals. Others slack off because their motivation is extrinsic or externally motivated by rewards such as money, fame, grades, or praise. Internally driven motivation is usually most effective because the person desires to put in the work to succeed. This is strongly linked to the intrinsic motivation principle of creativity, or the propensity for creativity to flourish when people are motivated by personal enjoyment of the work itself. 2. Keep a book of ideas. The most successful and creative people are often obsessive note-takers. They have a habit of writing things down, whether it's a stroke of genius that came to them in a moment of inspiration, or an interesting concept they read about. As great as your memory might be, when an insight comes to you, it's always best to put it into written form so you can go back and evaluate it later. Creative people also tend to be doodlers and list makers. They jot down to-do lists, places they want to visit, and books they want to read so they can refer to them later. 3. The more hours you work, the more productive you are. Just because you're working for 8, 10, or even 12 hours a day doesn't mean you're productive. Between breaks, distractions, and fatigue, the average employee working an 8-hour workday is only really productive for portions of the day. Furthermore, working too many hours can be detrimental to your health. According to a study of 85,000 people in the European Heart Journal, long working days can increase the odds of you having a stroke. Working more hours does not automatically mean you will get more done. Instead, block out times when you can work undisrupted by turning off notifications or closing your office door. Furthermore, make sure that you schedule time for breaks. Taking a breather will help you recharge and refocus so that you can get back to the task at hand. More on that in a bit. 4. You work best under pressure. Some people claim that working under pressure boosts their productivity. That may be true in small doses. For example, you may have an upcoming trip and you need to hustle so you can get away. Living like this on a consistent basis, however, isn't sustainable and usually only creates stress. Stress impairs both your health and work. It's long been linked to cardiovascular problems and can certainly make you less fun to work with. Because of all this, keep stress to a minimum. One healthy tip is to not wait until the last minute. Be aware of deadlines and set priorities to help with this. 5. Jumping right in will help you get more done. Some people recommend that you just jump right into your work without a plan. The idea is that as long as you're getting work done, you're making progress. This can be both true and not true. You may end up working on a key project for an entire day without having accomplished or even started any of your other key tasks. You were so focused on getting certain items done that you did it all without a plan. That's like driving across the country without a map or using GPS. A more productive approach would be to kick off your day by identifying key tasks and mapping out work time. That takes some preparation, but it will help you stay on track when you come across obstacles. 6. You must keep working until you're done with a task. I get it. Why start a project if you aren't going to finish it? Because sometimes stopping isn't a bad thing. Instead of forcing yourself to finish a task, even if you've hit a wall, identify a good place to stop and switch gears to another item on your to-do list. For example, if you've been doing data analysis all morning, take a break and respond to some important emails. This allows your brain to take a break from a problem it's been tackling. When you return to the original task, you may be refreshed enough to crank it out more quickly and effectively. 7. Multitasking is efficient. I can understand the theory. Working on two or three projects at the same time means you're getting more done. Unfortunately, multitasking just isn't possible. The neuroscience is clear. We are wired to be monotaskers, writes Cynthia Kabu, PhD, and Andre Machado, MD. One study found that just 2.5% of people are able to multitask effectively. And when the rest of us attempt to do two complex activities simultaneously, it is simply an illusion. If you take a good look at the times you've multitasked, you probably see that you switched focus from one thing to another too often to do either of them very well. This is deadly from a productivity standpoint. In short, don't multitask. Do one task at a time and then move on to the next. 8. Rewards boost productivity. While monetary or physical rewards can be used to boost productivity, they usually only last momentarily. Once a reward has been received, we eventually return to the same level of productivity. Instead of relying solely on rewards and incentives,
we hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.